last year interface, we calculated the critical angle for water air interface, and we calculated for glass water as well as for diamond. So these four values you are supposed to know. Now, what is the importance of this critical angle? Sometimes it is asked. This critical angle for glass is 42 degree. What do you mean by this statement? So what will be the answer? Yes.
When Anyone? The angle of incident light is 42 degree, the light will go parallelly to the surface of.
Okay. What is wrong in this statement? Any other? What is wrong in his statement?
Sir, it will be 42 times. It will be 42 times less than that of glass.
You are not giving answer of physics. You are giving something else. Any other? Who are the first person to answer? Raise bubble.
Vijit, sir.
And second, Krish Kumar, who?
Yes, sir.
Any third one?
Yes, sir. It means that when the incident ray is incident by the angle of incidence of 42 degree, the refracted ray refracts by 90 degree.
That is the statement is same as previous. I am asking what is wrong in his statement. Now, according to his, what he is saying, according to that statement, what he said, suppose this is the glass. He is saying when the angle of incidence is 42 degree, the ray will become parallel to the boundary. Is it correct? Yes?
No, sir.
No, sir. What is wrong here? What is wrong in this statement?
They're from denser.
From denser, it should go to rarer.
So, what you have to write in your statement? In your statement, what you have to change?
42 degree is incidented on a glass, then it will be refracted to with an angle of 90 degrees.
So, this is the case. This is the problem when you are writing the exam and you are coming, okay, everything right written, okay. No? And teacher is not giving marks. So this is you, according to your statement, this is the situation. But this is 100% wrong. No, we can't say it is correct. Everyone is knowing? It cannot be. So what you have to do, actually what should be? This is the situation. So how will you write in this in language? So ray of light will become parallel to the boundary while going from glass to air if angle of incidence is 42 degree. Now this statement is clear. This is called expression. There is no doubt. Whatever you are saying, it is completely understood by the others. So this is the meaning of a statement. When you are asked, what is the meaning of this? What do you mean by this statement? The statement should be written in clear way that there is no doubt. You are knowing that this is the situation, but you are saying something else. You are writing something else. So in your statement, your mind is not reflected, or what you are thinking, what you are understanding is not reflected. Naturally, you will not get marks. So what will be this statement means, or it means refracted ray become parallel or angle of refraction is 90 degree, no problem, you can write like that. Refracted ray become parallel to the boundary while going from or moving from, going from, okay, no problem. While going from glass to air, when angle of incidence in glass is 42. Here everything is clear. The ray must go from glass to air. Not glass from glass to water. Simply you are writing while going from glass to air is not written. That means another medium is free. It can be water also. It can be diamond also. That means which is wrong. So there is chance of doubt. So glass to air, when angle of incidence in glass is 42 degree. That is the meaning. And what will happen if angle of incidence become more than 42 degree in this case?
Total internal reflection.
It will return back, or it will return to the same medium glass following the law of reflection. So this we call total internal reflection will take place. So that is the meaning. Bending towards normal. Now, of course, the same thing. Okay, we got there. This is suppose this angle become 30 degrees. What will happen now? Whatever the angle of incidence, he adjusted in such a way that this angle become 30 degree. Now what will happen to this ray? Or you know, we ask complete the ray diagram. Will this ray return Will it be retraced? Yes? It will not be retraced because this surface is not parallel or this is not a mirror. So it will not be reflected. It will have a tendency to go from glass to air, emerge out. Now we will find what is the angle of incidence at this place. What is the angle of incidence at this place? Yes. Yes, what happened? What is the angle of incidence? 60
degree.
How much?
60 degree.
60 degree. So this is 30, this is 60, this is 90, this is 30, so this is 60 degree. Now what will happen? Like this, going from glass to air, so it will bend away from normal. Will it go like this? Is the ray diagram correct? Or should we come like this, this side? What is that?
No, sir.
No. Then? Is it correct?
No, sir. There will be total internal reflection.
So, while going from denser to rarer, always you keep in mind, after calculating angle of incidence, you see first whether this angle is more than critical angle or less than critical angle. So this angle of incidence is more than critical angle for glass. Your critical angle for glass is 42 degree. If it is not given, then you are supposed to know this one, use this one. So here angle of incidence become more than 42. So total internal reflection will take place. Now, it will have a tendency to move from here. Again, we will find this angle of incidence here. What is that? What is the angle of incidence?
Thirty degree.
So this is 60, this is 60, angle of reflection is here. So say this is 30, this is 90, this is 60, so this is 30 degree, which is less than critical angle. So it will emerge out. So this one will emerge out. What about this angle? Yes. What will be this angle? Anyone?
Put it 2 degrees.
Huh? 42 degrees. What is the relation between this angle and this angle?
Angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence.
What is the relation between this angle and this angle? Suppose this angle is say E. What is the relation between I and E? E is more than I, E is less than I, E is greater, half of
I.
Equal to I. So that is the relation.
Yes.
So this angle will be I. If you are asked, find the value of I, then what will be? Find I. Then how do you find?
Sin I by sin R is equal to 4 by.
So this one will be sin I over sin 30 equal to 1.5. So this sine I will be sine 30 half, that is 3/4. So this I will be approximately, I think, 48 degree, or 48 degree something will be coming. 49 degree will come. Okay, 48 degree some minute will come. So this only we can, this way only we can find. If especially it is asked, but in the question paper, if the I is given, then you are supposed to write here also I, because you are supposed to know principle of reversibility. Clear up?
Yes, sir.
Different arrow mark means in the refracted ray or emergent ray also you have to give same number of arrow so that we can know this angle be going in this direction. That is the meaning. So sometime in the question paper you will find this type of arrow mark. Okay, so this is was given. So, what is the angle of incidence? What is the value of angle of incidence at this place? Here, what is that? 0 degree. What is the angle of incidence at this place? 30 degree. This is 45 degree. This is 60 degree. This is 70 degree. Now, how will you complete the ray diagram? Yes?
First, you have to find critical angle.
So, first you will find the critical angle. So, what is the critical angle?
45 degrees. 45 degree.
So here critical angle will be refractive index of B with respect to refractive index of A, or simply 1 by refractive index of A with respect to B, whatever formula you can recall. So this IC is 45 degrees. Now it is very clear which ray will emerge out, which ray will be reflected. Yes, which ray will be reflected? These two will be reflected, where angle of incidence is here 60 degree, which is more than 45. This is reflected. What will happen to this ray?
It will run parallel to the boundary. Yep.
Parallel to? So this ray will become parallel. This ray will be reflected. And angle will be here 60 degree. This ray will also be reflected, and angle will be 70 degrees. So number of arrows is different just to show which ray is moving in which direction. In the question paper, if different number of arrows is given, then you are supposed to give in refracted ray or emergent ray different number of arrows. So in this case, what will be as it is? Less than 45 degree. So it will emerge out like this. If you are interested, you can find the angle also of what will come, but marks will not be deducted for that. So this angle, if you are interested, you can find. How will you find? Sine 30 by sine R will become refractive index of B with respect to A. So again, 1 by 2. So this R will be again 45 degrees. This will go undeviated. If you are not finding this angle, marks will not be deducted. Unless especially it is asked. So this way, if you are asked to complete the ray diagram, first of all, you will find either ray is going from denser to rarer. Refractive index is root 2 of this one. So it is going from rarer to denser. So you will always find the critical angle. If it is going from rarer to denser, whatever the angle may be, it will never be totally internally reflected, or it will never be parallel to the boundary. Always it will bend towards normal. Now suppose you are given 3 isosceles prism. Complete the ray diagram. So critical angle is supposed given 42 degrees. So here these two sides are equal, it is isosceles prism, sometimes it will be written. If nothing is written, that then also you have to assume if this type of figure is there, isosceles. If nothing is given. Okay, now what will be? So in this case, what is happening? As it is 90 degree, so this will go undeviated. Angle of incidence is 0 degree. What is the angle of incidence at that this place? This is 90, this is 40, this is 50, so this is 40 degree. What will happen? This angle is less than critical angle, so it will emerge out. So simply you will write this R will be more than 40 degree. No need to calculate. Because for more that extra credit will not be given. Now here, this is 90 degree, so this is your 50 degree. What will happen now? Yes?
Total internal reflection.
Total internal reflection. So it will not emerge out here. And the dependency is from glass to air, an angle of incidence become more than critical angle. So total internal reflection will take place. So it is reflected like this. So this is 50 degree. Now what is the angle of incidence at this place? At this point, what is the angle of incidence? More than 42 or less than 42?
Less than 42.
Less than 42.
Less than 42. So this is 50, 40. This is 40, this is how much?
60.
60. This is 50. How much will come?
65.
65. This is 65. This is 40. So 105. So naturally, this one will become how much?
65.
This is 40. So 105 here. Naturally, this will not be more than. So it will be coming like this. Okay. So this way. So this is 75. Understood? So what is the angle of incidence here? 15 degree. This angle is less than critical angle, so it will emerge out like this. And this angle we have tried only more than 15 degree. As it is going from glass to air, so it will move away from normal. Did you understand this part?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes. So before drawing this ray, you calculate what will be this angle. If it is more than 90, it will come like this, which one was drawn earlier. If it is less than 90, then it will come like this. Okay, now final this one. Yes. Completed. Yes. No one.
Done, sir.
Anyone got? So your figure. Put your video on. So your figure. No one want to show. See, all are sleeping only. You're not sitting with cup, pen and paper or what? So what will happen now? Here will go undeviated. What is the angle of incidence at this place?
60 degree.
60 degree.
50 degree.
Huh?
50 degree.
So it is more than critical angle. So what will happen?
Total internal reflection.
Total internal reflection. So this is 60. This is 30. So what will happen to this angle? At this place?
90 degree.
90 degree. So it will go undeviated.
Yes.
So while completing the ray diagram related to the ray while going from denser to rarer, you have to keep in mind whether you have to find angle of incidence at each surface, each boundary, everywhere. When it has got the tendency to go from here to see, here also it has a tendency to go from glass to air. We have to calculate angle of incidence and see whether it is more than or less than. Again, the ray has struck this surface. Again, at this surface, we will find angle of incidence. Here at this surface, angle of incidence was less than critical angle. So it is emerging out. If here again also angle of incidence is more, it will again return, reflect. So this is how to complete the ray diagram related to critical angle and total internal reflection. So frequently it is asked to complete the ray diagram. Okay, next we shall see the reflecting prism and its uses. So you have completed up to this 5 year up to calorimetry. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Two or three have said I have completed. Now we are not going to, just school is not going to start within 15 or 10 days. So you are supposed to make this answer, whatever you have done in PDF file, that 5 year in PDF file and send on my personal WhatsApp, not in the group one. Otherwise, other will copy from that answer only. So those who have completed, just you send on my personal WhatsApp number. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So thank you, sir.
Last day job by Sunday. By Sunday, you send That is your first internal assessment. And evaluation will be done online it only.
Is calorimetry only, sir, or this also reflection also?
Up to calorimetry. From light onwards, that will be your second internal assessment. So first will be up to calorimetry. So just you send, and light onward will be your second, that will be collected afterwards. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So make PDF, whatever pages are there, make PDF and then send. Understood? Okay, now we shall leave this. Thank you.